I'm Makenzie Read, the Waste and Resources Manager for the City of Knoxville. While more than half of eligible city households participate in our recycling program, we still get lots of questions. Like, is this material really being recycled? What can be recycled? Where do the items go? And what kind of products are made with my recyclables? To help you better understand the entire process, we took a trip to WestRock, our recycling processor, to give you a behind-the-scenes look at the cycle of recycling.
The City of Knoxville's curbside recycling program serves more than half of the city's 60,000 qualified households, helping residents recycle their plastic, paper, metal, and cardboard. No sorting required. Waste Connections picks up residents' recycling every other week and delivers it to WestRock, a materials recovery facility on Proctor Street. The facility's single stream system uses people, automation, and manual processes to sort materials by size, shape, and type. Employees pre-sort materials to remove large or contaminated items. People are also stationed at locations along the belt to remove contaminants like plastic bags and other non-recyclables. Non-recyclable items can break down the sorting equipment and negatively affect the quality of otherwise good recyclables. WestRock operators use different types of equipment to separate materials. The eddy current separator uses magnets to divide aluminum cans from tin cans. The optical sorter identifies the molecular makeup of an item and then uses a puff of air to send the item from the stream into its own separate pile to be baled. Here it's sorting number one plastics from other plastics. Next, crews sort materials into the baler, which compresses and then wraps the materials into a bale that is easy to stack and ship. Baled materials are ready to ship regionally to buyers from several industries that manufacture your recycled items into new materials. Did you know that WestRock operates several paper mills where they use reclaimed paper fiber to make new recycled paperboard, which is then used in a wide variety of food packaging and retail merchandise containers? Think about it. The Amazon and pizza boxes that you recycle may come back to you as new Amazon and pizza boxes. So who else buys recycled materials? The beverage industry buys aluminum cans and polyethylene terephthalate or PET plastic bottles to make into new ones. PET also ends up in lots of carpet manufactured here in our region. Industries that used recycled plastics in their products buy high-density polyethylene containers like plastic jugs and buckets to make into items like corrugated pipe, composite wood, or plastic lumber. So, when you buy products that include recycled content, you reduce the need for virgin materials, stimulate the recycling industry, and help create local and regional jobs in recycling, collection, and processing. And when you recycle with the city's curbside program, your items go to reputable end users who use them in the manufacturing of new products using recycled content.
To keep up to date with accepted materials and for a breakdown of what we recycled last year, check out our website, knoxvilletn.gov/recycling.